Hi, it's Stacye. How are you? Happy Thursday. I hope everyone is well. Thank you to everyone for reading and commenting on my last blog, What My Aunt Taught Me About My Aunt Alma. Thank you to everybody on MySpace, YouTube, Facebook, and soulfair.com. Thank you ever so. I hope everybody's well today. Still a lot going on in the world. And I'm going to say it again, do not panic. Don't panic. It's all going to be all right. It really is. This too shall pass. And we will be back where we want to be in no time at all. So moving on, let me say thank you to A Woman's Worthy, G.I. Joe, Colleen, Shelley, Ephraim, Charles, Roger, Arthur, Wayne, Chicky, and Chantel. Chantel, thank you so much, I'm personally saying, for the lovely video you sent me. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. It was heartfelt and very kind of you. Thank you. So tonight, my topic is, are you loving without fear? Two things brought this up. My Aunt Alma was married for 60 years. Even after my uncle died, I mean, first of all, they were always affectionate and loving towards each other, my aunt and my uncle Arville, but even after my uncle passed, and my uncle passed, like, my God, 15, 16 years ago, my aunt didn't mourn him, but she would just always talk about her lover and her man, you know? And she would just, until the day she died, she remembered that love and just really, you know, you sit there and go, God, I want that. I want somebody like that. But as some of you know on MySpace, I guess when every time someone comments on a blog, it shows up, and there was a comment on a very old blog I wrote, which is Keeping Love Alive, which I wrote in February, but Betsy, I think it is Betsy, commented on recently, a couple of days ago. And because of Aunt Alma, I thought about that, and then I thought about, okay, you know, we've talked about the economy and all those things, and you know, it's really just about safeguarding yourself and doing what you gotta do, and at the end of the day, that's all you can do, and roll with it. So let's move back on to more pleasant subjects, like building ourselves spiritually. So I decided I wanted to go back to love. So Betsy's question or statement was really, people ask her if she's with somebody, she says no. People ask her, is she afraid to be in love, and she said yes. And so here it is. The biggest obstacle any of us ever have about anything in our life is fear. We fear being rejected. We fear not having. We fear making a mistake. We fear someone not feeling the way we do. We fear being vulnerable. There's so many things that we fear. We allow fear to stop us from moving forward. But the reality is that how can you ever move forward if you don't let go of the fear? How can you have those things that you say you want? Our fears come from things that we've witnessed or come from things that we've experienced. We're always holding on to the, I don't want to say mistakes, just the unfortunate experiences we have in past relationships. Someone did something to us, now we're afraid everybody's going to do that to us. Okay, well, you got to let that go. Here it is. If you want to be in love, if you see that, you got to be able to see yourself in that type of a relationship, in the relationship that you think you want. That comes first, the first thing I always say, know yourself. Know what you need, what you want, what's important to you, and show who you are. And be, you know, communicate. Talk about those things. And be open and understanding to finding someone who's like-minded. Don't just jump in a relationship. I mean, that's part of the problem too. A lot of times we start dating and we fall into a relationship, and then here's two people, don't really know what they want, or maybe they do, and they're trying to make the other person be what they want, and they probably shouldn't be together in the first place. So now they do things to each other that the other person is gonna hold on and they're put in their luggage and carry on in their life. Well, this was done to me and that was done to me and I was hurt. You're hurt because you made a bad choice, because you chose to be in something that you probably shouldn't have been in. You chose to try to change someone. You chose to not listen to someone else's needs or you were in a relationship with someone that didn't really want to be in a relationship, and they were probably being very verbal, but a lot of times we think, oh, I can change this person, I can make them what I want to make them. You can't. You can't. A person is only who they are, just like you're who you are. You don't want anyone to try to You don't want anybody trying to change you, so therefore, you shouldn't try to change another person. So if you know who you are, you search for the like-minded. If you're clear about what you want and need and you're honest about what you want and need, that means dropping the armor. Who cares if you're vulnerable? Because at the end of the day, what you gain is the experience. You might spend 3 days with the wrong person, but if you're yourself, if you're vulnerable, and they're able to see who you are so that you can see more clear who they are, if they're not accepting of who you are, if there's a clash, then you don't have to waste any more time and find yourself 3 years down the line going, I had a bad relationship. You just don't waste your time and you move on. And you look for and wait for the more like-minded individual who needs what you need, who wants what you want. And then you can have that loving relationship. But you have to lose your fear of what can happen. We're so busy worrying about the what ifs and, you know, so-and-so did this to me. I don't want this to happen again. Okay, well, first of all, nothing ever really is the same. This was a different way that it happens. But it's really about living in the now, finding what's for you, be present, and be open. So, to Betsy and anybody else out there looking for love, I believe it's out there. I know that it's out there. But it's just about what you want, what you need, and what you're giving. Because I think if you can put all that in the pot and not be worried about, don't worry about the other stuff. Don't worry about the future. Tomorrow's not promised. Be in the present. Be accepting, be understanding, and be loving, be kind. You can be those things if you can be yourself. Show yourself. Love will show itself to you. And the right somebody will show themselves to you. So, I ask this question, and I expect answers. Ponder this. Are you loving fearlessly? Are you in relationships fearlessly? Are you going into them fearlessly? That is my question for the day. Ponder that. I will see you soon. Yeah, can you imagine 2 blogs in a row? I just have to be motivated. I'm sorry, and I get a little unmotivated. I've had a lot going on. Anyway, neither here nor there. I wish everyone a most pleasant Thursday. Be well, be safe, and I'd love to hear if you're living fearlessly. And if you're not loving fearlessly, tell me why you're not. Tell me why, and what are you afraid of? Maybe someone else is afraid, or maybe it's a fear I've had, and I mean, I admit I've been afraid, you know? Nobody wants to get hurt. We all fear being hurt, so I think that's the biggest one. You kind of got to get past that and just be in it and go, okay, well, that didn't work. Next. Anyway, have a great Thursday. I'll see you soon. Love and blessings.